Cosmos, yes, all I can say is that these things happen.
Well,
Human error.
it happens. I do not want to say it's going to be. I mean, I'm looking for some sort of euphemism to describe what I'm actually, what is actually in my mind right now, and what is in my mind right now is really, really livid, and it's so sad.
You should.
This is not human error.
No, you should be. No, but come on, you see. But Manu Garba said something that
there was a push, and I saw the video. I saw the video as well, and I saw that yes,
you know,
there was some sort of comfort.
The build up from when the camera panned to God Bless Asamoah finishing, it was a bit shaky. So you didn't really
was
see.
A bit shaky.
You didn't see where the ball was coming from.
Listen.
We didn't see
the ball was being crossed. Mm-hmm. Somebody nodded out.
Okay.
God bless Asamoah, and it crossed. Now, as at the time the ball was nodded out, a player of Rivers United and a player of Gombe United were probably struggling or marking each other. And before the ball was kicked back, both of them were not even touching each other. So where was that confrontation?
It's difficult.
The build up?
Let's see that video again. Maybe we can see what our referee, Sharafa Agbola, saw that we didn't see. And it was standing a very good view, saw everything, and
let's see the replay again.
Very
let's see the replay again. I wish you can just see the replay again, and you will see what I'm talking about. For me, as at the time, God bless Asamoah played that ball. Look at it. The ball was nodded out. Two players were holding themselves. Now watch. God bless Asamoah played the ball.
The referee flagged down.
No, listen. Look at those two players. They weren't even touching each other. Where is this thing here?
He could have even stopped it before the ball.
He could have stopped it before the ball even got to God bless Asamoah. The assistant referee didn't even raise his flag, and he should have raised his flag. The referee didn't blow, and it was at this time when the goal was scored. That was when the referee blew for an infringement. How do we referee in this country?
We've seen this almost everywhere. We've seen this in the English Premier League. We've seen this in the Italian Serie A. Human beings are in charge of this. And sometimes, you know, football is frenetic. It's too quick. It's too... sometimes you don't just know and then it just happens, you know. I'm just trying to understand the situation at the Fantasy Stadium.
Wow.
Where Gombe United defeated Rivers United by a single goal. But again, hard work.
Very
more true. Work for the league management company. Officiating has to be top notch. Yes, we can accept some errors, but there are some that you just see and you start asking questions,
and we
don't need it for our football.
Please, we need all the games on television. If that game was on television, trust me, something like this probably wouldn't happen.
But you analysts also come. We saw Remo Starzabia Warriors, was it on television?
Well, Remo Starzabia
still made noise about the calls.
Well, and it was because people watched the game, people saw it, and that's why we were able to talk. That's why we had an informed analysis about it. Put these games on television, and this game was on Sunday, for goodness sake. We're talking about it on Tuesday. We would have been talking about it immediately. That is what I'm talking about.
None of the games were live on TV.
Exactly.
Match Day 17. So that's it, Nigeria Professional Football League. We love what we're seeing this season. We're enjoying the competition, but officiating should also be part of what we should come out and say. We've also seen games this season, Cosmos, that... away team says good officiating.
Exactly.
You know, home team even lose the game and say good
of
officiating.
Certainly.
That's what we want.
Certainly. We've seen stuff like that. Yeah. A lot of people are saying that home teams win. As far as I'm concerned, if the officiating is good and the home team win well, come on, we should congratulate the referee.
Talk about things like this. Very tiring. So let's go to the Nigeria National League now. That one also getting competitive. We told you Delta Force, they've lost their first game of the season. It's really, really getting competitive. Bayelsa United still going on strong. At the end of the season, what are the teams that can eventually make it up to the Nigeria Professional Football League? There's also Papillo FC giving their bit in that one. Let's just run through the fixtures. Southern Conference, AS Racine. We'll take on Warri Wolves. Warri Wolves still struggling. Let's see if they can bounce back in that one. Bayelsa United, we'll play Aqua Starlets. Won their last game 3-0, defeating AS Racine. Let's see what they can do. I'm going to, I think, Nembe to play Bayelsa United.
Yeah,
difficult ground. Let's see. Bedel Insurance also still struggling. We'll see if they can bounce back against Abia Comets. Crown FC will take on Unisem Rovers. still on the Southern Conference. Delta Force and Papillon FC, that one should give us good talking point. Mm-hmm. Let's see if Delta Force can bounce back after that defeat to Osun United. First Bank will play Osun United. Let's see if Osun United can give us back-to-back victories in the league. In the way, United will play My People FC. Gateway will take on Ikorodu. Ikorodu needs to start winning. Still struggling. While go round, we'll play Heartland. So that's it. Some fixtures in the Nigeria National League right there. Second tier division of the league. So winners from this league get promoted to the Nigeria Professional Football League. And what we're trying to do is let you follow it so that at the end of the day, you start asking, which are the teams that got promoted? So work with us now. The league is just starting so that you get to know those teams that will gain promotion and the ones that will go down in the NNL. Let's take a look at the English Premier League now. Games going on live. It's now Leicester City 2, Islas Slimani and Jamie Vardy with the goal. So this resurgence continues after they told their coach, you can go.
By Shakespeare.
That's Shakespeare writing.
Shakespeare.
Good stories for us now with Leicester City. So Burnley 1, Stoke City 0, Leicester City 2, Sunderland 0, Watford winning against West Brom, but 2 goes to nothing. But that's the talking point right there.
Manchester
United and Everton. Manchester United, they need to do all they can to get something.
And they have dropped to the sixth position now. Everton has leapfrogged both Arsenal and Manchester United to the fifth position. And it's life right now. Anything can still happen. Manchester United just need a draw to get back to the fifth position. And Everton will come back to seventh position because Arsenal has more goal than them. But let's just see how it goes. I mean, this season's English Premier League, especially towards the twilight end, match day 30.
I tell you.
Actually very, very interesting. Eight more games to go. Anything can happen. Fine. Arsenal and of course Manchester United have a game in hand. But then, very, very interesting. Jack Hager scoring wonderful goal in the 22nd minute.
That's right.
And you want to ask yourself that Everton, that is suggest, you need to see them against Liverpool. Liverpool actually won because they were probably the lucky side. It wasn't as if they were better than Everton, but it was a very interesting game. And Jai Kega at Old Trafford scoring. Anything happens here, Everton wins. Everton will be gunning for that top four as well.
That's right.
But Manchester United needs to do that. You know, needs to get at least a draw. Not good times for Jose Mourinho right now. So Mourinho fighting all of his players. If he's not Luke Shaw,
that's Jose for you.
I mean,
that's
no lot of players. So even Ibrahimovic is here, but I mean, nothing is happening.
Let's set the record straight. The games we mentioned before: Burnley, Stoke City, Leicester, Sunderland, Watford, and West Brom all concluded. The game between Manchester United and Everton, we're now in the 87th minute. So who can turn things around for Manchester United now? Let's see. Arsenal. Wenger says top four finish is not easy.
I'll follow in the interview this morning. I mean, pre-match press conference this morning, actually said that it's not particularly easy. I mean, yes, he's been getting into it in the past 20 years. It's not easy. And even mentioned the fact that even Pep Guardiola is even saying that in England, the top four is a trophy.
Yeah.
Ibrahimovic as well said it this morning, So, wow. So, it's a trophy in England.
So, that's why you love your English Premier League. Even Antonio Conte says the league title race is now more interesting. Thank you so much, Cosmos, for coming around.
Thank you so much, Austin.
And to you, wherever you're watching Sports Tonight on Channels Television, the action never ends. Keep talking to us on Twitter, Channels_Sports, Facebook, Channels Life Sports. That's the show. On behalf of the team, I'm Austin Okonakwan. In everything you do, remember, keep talking sports. Bye for now.